Very punctual, coming in from Orlando, Florida. Kent Bazemore. Baze, it's Dave and Jay. Hello, how are you?
I'm doing good, guys. Thanks for having me on.
First question's a simple one. How's the bubble? Can you compare this? Is this like college dorms? Is this like summer camp? Is there any comparison at all?
No, not really, man. It's kind of eerie. You know, we've been here, I don't even know how long now, but I went and played golf the other day, and there were like cars and people walking around, and, you know, being inside, it just feels like the world is stuck, you know, on the outside because everything's so, you know, airtight here. But, you know, it's just kind of good to see, you know, that civilization is still moving around outside of the bubble. I mean, they're doing a really good job of, you know, having this live up to its name.
Well, we've seen Buddy catching fish. Marvin Bagley dropped a new album. We saw pictures of you playing golf, and believe me, we're going to get to that in a second. I'm fascinated. But other than being able to golf, which was just recently, you were able to exit the bubble and do that. How are you, other than practice and film and stuff, how are you passing the time?
Just working on, you know, little projects, doing some stuff back home, you know, some education initiatives with my foundation and whatnot, and you know, just resting and, you know, catching up with old teammates. You know, I mean, it's plenty to do. It's just all in, you know, what you want to do. So, I mean, I think they've done a good job of, you know, focusing on the mental health aspect of giving guys, you know, options, you know, to do different things. But it's, you know, it's still, you know, you'd love to go home and, you know, after a long day of practice and, you know, play with your son and see your wife and all that good stuff. But, you know, that's what kind of makes it tough when those things start kind of creeping in the mind a little bit.
Coach Walton was saying how impressed he's been with you guys and how mentally you have all been there and been sharp. How difficult has it been in that environment to kind of, you know, for lack of a better word, stay sane when you're pretty much quarantined in a room? And you kind of just stuck with, well, we got practice, we can eat meals, we stay in a room, you get out every once in a while. How hard has it been for the team to just kind of stay on track and keep that goal of making that 8 seed?
Well, when you know, basketball, the gym is probably everyone's sanctuary. So when we're in there, you know, we're focused on, you know, the task at hand. You know, that's something that's understood, you know, trying to get the 6 seed. So, when we step on the floor, we step in the court, you know, none of that stuff matters. You know, we just kind of leave it, you know, right outside the gym, and you can pick it up on the way out if you want to, but, you know, that just depends on how practice went.
Kent Bazemore joining us. Kent, did I hear right? You know, it's tough to get accurate news out of the bubble. Did they shut down your pancakes and sausage?
Yeah, they shut me down, man.
Come on, man. Come on.
It was fun while it lasted.
What was it? Brecky with Baze? Is that what we were calling it?
Yes, sir.
So if
my wife calls Brecky, so I stole that name from her.
If I heard right, or if I got this right, so you grabbed the griddle off of Amazon. I think the pancake mix was something you already used. You grabbed some sausages, and you were just doing up your own breakfast in your room, and you know, did you get caught on the tip line or was that the hotel?
I guess because I posted the picture.
Oh.
Yeah, I mean, but I cook a lot, you know, I cook a lot at home. I love cooking, you know, breakfast, lunch, and dinner. My wife's a great cook. So, we cook a lot and, you know, it's just part of, you know, putting the work in, it's just something I felt like I had to do. I wasn't really satisfied with, you know, what we were having early on. And I just took it upon myself to make sure, you know, I stayed on top of my body because, you know, I put in a lot of work, you know, over the past 24, 30 months of just, you know, trying to get my body to where it is and putting the right stuff in it. And, you know, it's an investment. So I just took it upon myself to, you know, kind of do what I had to do. And, you know, since then, everything's gotten a lot better. Food has gotten a lot better, way more options. You know, they opened up, you know, for breakfast downstairs at this restaurant. It's really good. So, things have turned ever since that picture went up. So it was a sacrifice that I was willing to take.
Kent Bazemore joining us. We alluded to it a little bit earlier, Kent, seeing you out on the golf course. Golf, a big part of what you do. How long you been playing? Like, I was impressed.
Yeah. Golf is an amazing sport. It's an amazing outlet. It's probably the only thing that I've you know, been able to fully submerge myself in. You know, when you start talking about mindfulness and stuff, you know, it's only, you know, place outside of basketball that I can just go and kind of lose myself in and forget about everything else. And, you know, I think that's really important, you know, not only while I'm here, but just in life. You know, it's just been, it's helped me layer the game. It's given me perspective to the game of basketball, because growing up, I just looked at, you know, we just going to play basketball. But, you know, you playing golf, you say, you know, I got a par four, I got, you know, a bunker 260 out. Do I want to lay up short of that? Do I want to carry it? You know, if I carry a bunker, fairway gets smaller. So, you know, it's just, you know, when you start layering the game of golf and you apply to basketball, you know, it just slows your thought process down. You're able to kind of dissect the play. You know, obviously the game is a lot faster, but it does give you that depth of perspective to, you know, elevate your game on the floor. And, you know, it's giving me this calm and confidence about myself. Because you can't be, you know, you can't really have individuality in basketball. So I spend that time on the golf course. You know, if it's 220 over water and I want to carry it, I'm going to go for it. But, you know, basketball, I'm a team guy. I'm a team first guy. It's not about me. And, you know, basketball is kind of where I can go and be selfish.
Kent Bazemore with us. I'm just going to quick fire you some questions because now we're in the wheelhouse here. I do want to go back to the cooking in a second, but all right, so are you a Pro V1 guy? Let's check the bag first. What balls are you playing?
Team TaylorMade, baby. TP5X.
Okay, TP. Wow. All right. What clubs are we rolling out? Same TaylorMade?
Yeah, TaylorMade. I got 3-4 and a 5 and the 790 and 6-2 pitching wedges and 760.
TaylorMade 3-wood is the best 3-wood I've ever hit in my life. I'm a ping guy.
Oh, no question.
I'm a ping guy, but I keep that TaylorMade 3 in my bag.
Ping solid.
Mm-hmm. Let's see. What are you hitting your 7-iron at these days?
7-iron's probably 185.
Damn. Okay.
Yeah, damn. I step on it, yeah.
So, Dave, 7-iron's only 85. So
my 185 is like 155, 160. But so I'm guessing you're driving what? High twos, low threes?
Yeah, probably 295.
Yeah. Strength in your golf game. What's your strength? One thing.
Short game for sure.
Okay, what's the weakness?
Yeah. Probably long irons.
Okay.
You been impressed with any of your teammates on the golf course, or are you just kind of waxing them?
I've only played, bogeys come a long way really quick. I got to see Kyle Guy swing it a little bit. I play with Bobby Jackson a lot. We play against each other a lot.
Okay, can I stop you? I played with Bobby Jackson a few times, and I will tell you this. Does Bobby still do the thing? Because Bobby plays Pro Vs unless he's changed in the last month. And Bobby made something like, I tell him this all the time, $400 million or something during his career. And that dude will, for how short he is and how wide he is, and he puts that rear end into it, and he'll blast it 330. But does he still look for every single ball in the rough for like 20 minutes, or has he gotten better?
Oh, no, he's definitely gotten better. Okay. His pace of play has been really good since we've been playing.
Okay.
But, no, he can hit the ball. He can hit the ball a mile for sure.
Yes, he can.
And like I said, we go back and forth as far as, you know, the wins and losses. We get a little money gains. Nothing crazy, but, you know, just a little bit.
And then what was the other thing I was going to ask you? Oh, yeah. Have you had a chance to play much here locally in SAC? I know you haven't been here forever, but have you had a chance to check out?
Oh, yeah.
Okay, good.
Okay. For sure. Yeah, I played Teal Bend. Uh-huh. That's probably my favorite little public course because it's, you know, never really crowded. It's kind of challenging. Played Wild Horse. I went up to, was it Winchester?
Winchester.
Up in Auburn.
Yep.
with my buddy Hannah, and then play Yocha.
Uh-huh.
Yocha D, he's nice. Yep. I play Del Paso. Mm-hmm. And, shoot, yeah, I think that's it.
You play Cata Vadera yet? Up in
yeah, I have played Cata Vadera, okay. Yep.
Winchester's my favorite. No offense to Yocha if you can get on, but Winchester's my favorite local course.
It's tough.
It is, so but there's tough. There's a couple of tee boxes though that are elevated. Like that first one at Yocha, the first tee that's bro. But if you lay into one, you're the whole rest of your round. I feel like it's either a really great way or a really bad way to start your round.
For sure. Yeah, I hit driver like all the way down there, up the left side. So we had a little downwind off the right. So I just, try to hit a big drop into it, and it took it way down there.
Talking to Kip Bazemore, Kings guard right now. As much as I love all the golf talk guys,
I don't care.
My bad.
No, you got
it. My fault.
We asked the questions. You're just giving the answers. Don't apologize for our stupidity.
Ask a real question.
Jay. I was just going to say, with different guys coming in and out of the bubble, obviously Alex Lynn, Buddy, shown up late because of the COVID issues, Harrison not shown up. Has it been a little bit difficult to try to get rhythm in practice, given that you basically have guys coming in and out versus you got guys that haven't showed up yet? Has that rhythm been difficult to get into?
No, we're still dialing in the principles right now. We just, just trying to make sure that, the Kings are playing to their strengths, and, it's a universal system here in Sacramento. So, with Harrison being, the professional he is, we don't really, I don't think it's going to take him long to get back into it. Alex just got here. It was good to see him. And, with guys, kind of trickling in, it really, builds the morale, that we're getting closer to full strength. Jabari Parker's looked really good over the last couple of days. And, our younger guys are getting a lot of reps. Daquan, Justin, and Kyle are getting a lot of reps. So we're still building the depth, and I think that'll pay big dividends here. With all these games coming up, just having a bunch of guys that come in and give you some minutes.
Sacramento King Kent Bazemore joining us. That's great. Let's go back to the cooking now. So you can tell which one of us is sports focused. That's him. And Kent and I are over playing, talking golf.
Golf and pancakes. It's your new podcast.
All about balance. All about balance.
You're obviously a student of the golf game, but you hit me with the cooking thing. So are you with your cooking? See, you and I have that in common too. And that's probably the only things we have in common. You cook for health and because your body's a Ferrari and a lot of those reasons. I cook because I'm a big fatty that likes to eat, but it is a relaxing hobby to me. It's something that's very satisfying to me. Are you anywhere near with your cooking game as you are with your golf game? Are you a student of cooking, or you just like to chop it up in the kitchen and make stuff?
Yeah. So I kind of have my go-to meals. Mm-hmm. I don't really, my wife is the one that kind of, get outside the box a little bit and try all this new stuff. But I kind of have things that, I know that's going to, I know how I'm going to feel the next day, or, if I need, if I feel a little bit like, drained or weak, I know I need to, go all in on some protein or something. I just kind of cook based on how I feel. And, it's kind of work. If I had, a really big lunch and I'm not that hungry at night, but I know I still need to eat, I'll just go straight veggies or something. It's fun. It's just another part of what brings everything together.
Give me some sample Bazemore menu meals if you're cooking. Dinner, breakfast, lunch. What are the first things that come to mind that if we were coming over and you were trying to impress us with your skills, what you'd throw on the table?
I mean, we do this this tofu. We drain tofu. We cube it. We chop it. We cube it, and then we put it in some olive oil and some arrowroot.
Okay.
So it breads a little bit. Then we put it in the oven for about 20-25 minutes. You toss it in, whatever sauce you like. It'd be barbecue, buffalo. So it's like, it's almost like chicken nuggets, but it's tofu. It has a little bit of crunch to it, so it's nice. And then I throw you some kale and probably some chickpea mac and cheese. So the chickpea pasta is It's really good. It's just started to come out, and you know the cheese is like vegan cheese, but it tastes exactly like macaroni and cheese. So it's amazing. So that'd probably be a meal. You know, that's one of my big power meals right there. Like, you know, I wake up the next day feeling like $100.
Now, is it all? Because that sounds, there's a lot of healthy stuff in there. And
that's where you lost it, by the way.
And that's fine. Is there a, if you're just letting it go, like what's a Kent Bazemore letting it go meal? Like, I don't care. It's cool. It's the weekend.
12 wings and some sweet potato fries.
That's what I'm saying. Okay. Yeah. Wings and fries. You been to Fire Wings before?
That's about it, though. I mean, that's about as much as I'll do. I'm probably 90% vegetarian.
Okay.
So the other 10% is all wings. Right? It's just wings.
We had Harry on last week. I asked him the same question. Have you knocked out Fire Wings here locally or no? Have you been there yet?
I can't say I have.
Okay. I'm going to 21 flavors of wings. Best wings in the world. I'm not
21.
Breaded Malaysian curry, buffalo, you have regular lemon pepper. They have a peanut butter wing, that which is like the peanut sauce in like an Asian noodle salad. That will blow your mind. Wow. A little bit of spice on it. I'm going to Harry knows all of that. Next time you see Harry, ask him about Fire Wings, and he'll lay it down for you. It's the best wings in Sacramento.
I'll do that.
Okay. Jay,
do that for sure.
Jay, you ask a real question now.
Oh, you want to go back to
basketball.
I'm sorry. I was getting into the whole food and the chickpea mac and cheese and the wings and potato fries.
How could you not?
Forgot Kent actually plays basketball, and that's something they're going to do. You know, when you came over, the trade from a, let's just put it from a national media perspective, didn't get a whole lot of hoopla, but I felt like when you came over and you and AT gave the, you know, the speech we've heard about in the locker room, letting the guys know, hey, we are way better than this record indicates. Talk a little bit about what you saw in the team that A, made you feel that way, and B, we've seen it now translate on the court. Talk about that process of getting out of that terrible losing streak. And, you know, pre-COVID-19, you guys were playing the best basketball of the season for this team.
Yeah, when you see teams, you know, get hot like Sacramento, like they do with all the shooting, like, you know, it's special. You know, Buddy, Bogey, Belly, Fox and Obercourt, Harrison, you know, Corey Joe running the show in the second unit. You know, you just got all the speed. You know, they got length. You know, defensively they compete. You know, when you have those kind of tools, you know, when you look at a team and you watch them play and you have those kind of tools, it's like, wow. And, you know, with those guys being so young, and I just, you know, when we first game, I just loved how, you know, they weren't afraid to get on each other. You know, being a young team, you know, some guys you can't really say anything to because, you know, they're going to shell. But guys are really, really receptive to you know, criticism, constructive criticism. And that says a lot. You know, that shows that guys want to win, guys want to play hard and all that. And 18, I saw that. We saw how the ball moved. We saw how the bench was into it, you know, led by Justin. You know, he's over there. He got the guys going, bringing the energy on the road. So those are a lot of the boxes that you want to check off in order to be a team, you know, that competes every night. And we saw that, and, you know, all it was just a little shot in the arm saying, hey, guys, like, we can play with the best of them. We showed it. Let's go out and do it.
Kent Bazemore joining us. I will ask a basketball question. And A, I know this is a business. And B, I know you're not going to, while you're playing for the team, coming on their local morning sports show and say, yeah, I don't really like it here. So this is kind of a, but you're an honest dude. And I get that from your interviews. You're finishing up a pretty nice contract. You're going to be a free agent this summer, but you have made some comments about Sacramento and about the team and the city and all that. So, I mean, legit, I take you at your word, but you got to work out the business end, but it does seem like you're definitely open to sticking around and being a part of this movement here for a while.
Yeah, I mean, at the end of the day, you know, loyalty is really hard to find, you know, at this level. You know, I was in Atlanta for 5 years, and that's a very long time in the NBA. You know, I think there's only two guys in the NBA now that have been with their teams, you know, their entire career, and that's Steph and Udonis Haslem. You know, before that, Tim Duncan, Kobe, Dirk. You know, it's not often that you get, you know, to go, but being in the position that I was over the past 2 years, you know, season and a half, two seasons, you know, I was, wasn't really playing my best basketball, and I came to Sac, and like there was just like this, you know, this warmth of, you know, just injected with, you know, a lot of confidence. You know, teammates believed in me, and not saying this was any different anywhere else, but you know, some stuff just feels right. You know, so you know, I got out there on the floor, I got my feet wet, and then I just kind of, you know, started playing my best basketball again. And you know, when you get those kind of feels, you know, you just kind of want to stay in there and ride the wave as long as you can.
Kent Bazemore with us from the Orlando bubble. Kent, it's the first time we've had a chance to talk to you, but just watching you and watching your interviews and how you deal with the media and the type of dude you seem to be, we've wanted to touch base for a while. Hope you had half the fun we did. We appreciate you taking the time to check in with us, and I hope we get to talk to you soon in this abbreviated season.
Yes, sir. Anytime, man. I'm, you know, I ain't doing nothing down here but practicing and playing golf. So, but all the time, man.
And then when you get back, if you ever need, if you never need a double for a Winchester, I'm telling you, I will make you feel good about your golf game. I can promise you that. That's all I can offer. You'll feel good.
All right. Cause let's do it.
I'm terrible. All right, buddy. I appreciate you. Thank you. Take care.
All right, gentlemen.
All right.
It's the Carmichael Dave Show on Sports 1140 KHTK.